Well, we know a decrease in the interest rate leads to an increase in investment spending. This increase in investment spending will increase aggregate demand, and that will affect prices and also the income level. Now, we need to illustrate this graphically. We start with a diagram showing the relationship between interest rate and investment spending. We know this relationship is inverse, therefore the investment demand curve has a negative slope. We need to show a decrease in the interest rate. Start with interest rate I1. Now there's a decrease in interest rate, say to interest rate I2. This decrease in interest rate leads to an increase demand for investment funds to I2. This is the first part of our chain of causality. Now, investment spending is part of aggregate demand. So this increase in investment spending increases aggregate demand. So we need to illustrate that as well. For that, we need to draw a diagram of the ADA's model, showing the relationship between prices and the income level. The aggregate demand curve and the aggregate supply curve and our initial equilibrium position P1, Y1. Now we have an increase in aggregate demand. An increase in aggregate demand is illustrated by a rightward shift of the aggregate demand curve. This leads to a new equilibrium position at P2, Y2. So the increase in aggregate demand increases the price level in the economy and also increases the income level in the economy.